Hello, BC. Welcome back. Next installment with the Analog Productions. And as you may have seen in the title, Ladies First. So today I put out some records from female artists. And let's get right into it. First record, quite new, at least as a 45 round per minute. I think it was out at 33 round per minute. Joan Baez, live concert in Bilbao, Spain, in a bullring. Nice cover, quite beautiful. The paintings are from Joan Baez herself. Record is called Diamonds and Rust in the Bullring. Great recording, very beautiful live concert, great atmosphere. The first record is in English. Second record, or second side if you have the 33, is in Spain, Spanish. Has some covers, Let It Be, she covers Let It Be over here, and the whole atmosphere on that concert is great and put very, very great on that record. Let me see if it's done again from Kevin Gray. Probably. I can find it here now. I think it's Kevin Gray. So very nice edition. As I said, the 45 round per minute is quite new. Definitely one to get. So next is also new, Helen Mirren. Helen Mirren is an actress. Helen Mirren, also quite new edition from Analog Productions. And I'm really happy that they put out it in this way, and they did a great job with that one once more. I hope there are another editions coming from her. Great mood, great recording, very beautiful photographs in this one. So highly recommended, great record. It's a record you could put on every time of the day. She sings so beautiful, great songs on it. So the next lady, and this is a great one. Sound-wise, it's a top record, top. Ricky Lee Jones at the 45 round per minute. It's like this, and when I first heard it, I was stunned. I hadn't much expectation, but this is one of an edition which has demo quality. I hadn't expected that, but this is stunning. Really great, really great one. Now we go with the Julie London recordings from Analog Productions. And this one is a bit problematic. I don't know if I had bad luck with my copy, but this one, at least on my copy, maybe I had bad luck and get a bad copy, has a lot of noise floor. So I was quite disappointed with that one, but maybe it's just my copy. As I'm in Germany, it's quite difficult for me to get a refund and get returning, so I can't compare it with a different one. And I don't know if I want to risk buying another one and hope that it's better. Maybe if you have that one, please tell me if you also have that much noise floor and quite disappointing, although it's a great record, of course, but I got probably bad luck with my copy. Quite different with this one again, Julie London. Originally they came out on Liberty, and this is a great one, very beautiful. Great record, great pressing, great mastering. Highly recommended. last of the three which are out up to now. Another Julie London, Latin in a Saddened Mood, and this is my favorite of these three recordings. They are still available. No hustle to get them, which is of course a good thing, but someday also these editions will be gone, and then I have to pay high prices, I'm quite sure, because there won't be much audiophile labels who would jump on that train again. So take your chance while it's there. Linda Ronstadt. Simple Dreams. Very successful album in its time. Very successful. She really sold a lot of records. Nowadays, it's not much talk of Linda Ronstadt, but Mezzi did, of course, who else? Mezzi did a great video on her 75th birthday, put out some great records from her. If you are into Linda Ronstadt, look that video, it's quite informative. Great one. Availability on this one is also good, no problems to get it. And as I said before, catch them while they are out there. This one belongs, in my opinion, on every list when it comes to the 20 best audiophile recordings. And I haven't seen her on that list, but she belongs there. Janis Ian, Breaking Silence. It's huge recording. I'm so happy to have it. I'm so happy that I discovered that record, and it's a pop folk, great record, beautiful songs, and in a stunning and in a miraculous beautiful recording and pressing. It's also of course a 45, and this one is one of my favorites. Still available and definitely worth trying out. And now a very special recording again. Shelby Lynn, Just a Little Loving. And this is a record when you get new equipment or new speakers or new whatever in your hi-fi system. This record has her voice, her singing, so well put in the center that I always take out this recording and listen if everything runs as it should be. You know, you need those kind of recordings which you know very, very well. Or a song maybe is also enough, and you have to know the song very, very well so that you can compare when you get new stuff or try out this different positioning of your speakers or get new cables, and so that you immediately can say what has changed. And this is a record which is very, very good when it comes to the positioning. If you want to be sure that everything in your sound stage is where it has to be, I always use this record because she is dead centered and absolutely correct. Absolutely correct. There was some She self put a lot of effort in that recording, and then it went wrong, and quite dramatic. I think Michael Fremer talks about that in one of his videos. I don't know which one. And she really puts a lot of effort into this recording. It's marvelous. Not that it's on good for checking out your system. It's such a beautiful recording, and her presentation is so well done, and you can't go wrong with this record. Highly, highly, highly recommended. Maybe also if you're newer to the audiophile theme and want to get into this section of vinyl, this is also a perfect showcase of on which this travel can get you. Gorgeous, gorgeous. So, finally, the last one for today with the ladies. Of course, Dusty in Memphis. Most famous song on that one is, of course, Son of a Preacher Man. Beautiful recording. And quite an important album in the history of music, and especially for Dusty Springfield. A really great man, belongs in every collection. Doesn't matter what pressing, but you will have this record. This is a 45 edition from Analog Productions, and important, great recording, must have. What else shall I say? So that's it with our ladies video. Maybe there will be another one. I thought about putting Norah Jones in it, but I think she gets her own video, as there are enough stuff for putting that into one video, and I don't want to have my videos too long. I think 12 to 15 minutes of me is enough for one evening, probably. Okay, that's it for today. Hope you liked it, and let's hear the lady sings. Thanks for your time. See you. Bye.